my next question was, I know that if you take cultured cells in a dish and you just, you're doing some, you know, specific nutrient withdrawal, you withdraw amino acids, or you withdraw glucose, or you withdraw glutamine, or you can induce autophagy. But in the whole organism, for example, in mice, in humans, ultimately, you know, can you just limit your protein intake for a week and induce autophagy, even in the presence of a normally caloric diet where you're still getting enough energy?
That's a good question. We have never tested selective depletion of one or the other nutrient. I suppose that this would work because protein depletion may affect neuroendocrine factors like insulin growth factor that at the end will, due to its depletion, decrease the transport of glucose into the cells and hence stimulate autophagy. But it has not been tested thoroughly in mice. What we usually do is we starve mice and sometimes human volunteers completely from any kind of caloric uptake. And in this case, we do see at the whole body level that in all major cell types, perhaps with the exception of the brain that is somehow buffered against this effect, protein deacetylation occurs mostly in the cytoplasm.
And that's a biomarker of autophagy, you would say?
Well, it's too early to say that it is a surrogate or proxy of autophagy. So far, we have not been able to dissociate the two phenomena, autophagy and protein deacetylation in the response to nutrients. Mm-hmm. However, when you induce autophagy by pharmacological tricks, such as a cell-permeable peptide that dissociates an inhibitory interaction between a Golgi protein and Beclin-1, you can induce autophagy without that protein deacetylation would occur before. And similarly, when you give chemical inhibitors of mTOR, like rapamycin or the rapalox, there's also no protein deacetylation. Mm. So you can induce autophagy without protein deacetylation, which means that the proxy would be imperfect. So we do have a system to measure autophagy, which is relatively easy to be used in experimental systems, which is the study of the redistribution of LC3 and other members of the same family that are usually diffusely distributed all over the cell, mostly in the cytosol, and then will aggregate or redistribute towards autophagosomes and autolysosomes. So they acquire a punctate distribution, small dots in this cell in the cytoplasm, and these dots can be seen by fluorescence microscopy if LC3 is labeled by immunofluorescence, or when it is fused with green fluorescent protein or similar biosensors.